It is what it is. Shannon, what is your reaction to what Baker said?
If nobody cares, why are you bringing it up? Ain't nobody asking about no injury. Why you brought it up?
He got asked.
No.
Yes, he did.
It's kind of like you on social media. I'm on social media. You might post something. Nobody cares. Well, then why you comment if you didn't care? Mm. Clearly you cared. I didn't hear anything about this the most beat up I've been after Cincinnati. Mm. I didn't hear none of that. Mm. Against Cincinnati, it was Odell. No Odell. Mm. Ooh, everything was perfect. Mm. Now he beat the hell. Wow. Really, Skip? Mm. I fought Odell. Mm. Because in talking to Odell, he wasn't able to get everything that he needed out of Cincinnati. Mm. He still has some clothes, some furniture, a car still there. So yep. Maybe the remnants is still left, is hovering over this team. Mm. The aura. That's what you guys say, because Odell's the easy excuse. Because anybody that plays bad, Odell's on the team. It's yep. Odell's fault.
Well, obviously, the Monday night loss, Odell's debut, it was Baker's fault, right?
No. I didn't blame that. No. The Rams didn't play well. You know they didn't play
somehow
well.
Somehow Baker got blamed for that. No,
so, a guy that's 25th in QB, because I wonder what Pro Football Focus. Oh, here, as a matter of fact, Pro Football Focus, I ain't got to ask. Mm. Pro Football Focus says Baker Mayfield is 25th in QBR. Mm. That's behind Daniel Jones, Teddy Turndown, and Jacoby Brissett. Mm. Mm. Ooh, Skip. 8 quarterbacks on this list in QBR that's ahead of him. 4 of them are rookies. Mm. It's amazing. I kept telling you, just because you're the number one overall pick, it doesn't make you great. He's very average. Mm. He needs everything. The Job effect. Mm. Everything around him needs to be perfect. Mm. But Job didn't need that because he was devout in his faith.
I don't get the Job effect, but
here's the thing.
Yeah.
If everything is perfect, mm-hmm. remember what he said?
Yeah.
The devil told him, say, the reason why you gave Job everything, look at all this. Mm. Family, wealth, cattle, livestock, you give him everything. That's why he served you. Mm. Take that away from him. Mm. Baker Mayfield can be that as long as he got Nick Chubb and Kareem Hunt. Mm. As long as the defense gave him 3 takeaways. Mm. Remove that and he will.
You realize Job won in the end.
Exactly.
Right? Okay.
But he can't win without Chubb, without Hunt. Skip, the man got 3 all-pro offensive linemen. You told me you love Peoples Jones. You love Jarvis Landry. You love Njoku. You love Austin Hooper and Bryant. Mm-hmm. You love all those. There is no Odell. There was no reason for him to play this bad. Mm-hmm. Don't bring up something that you said nobody care about unless you want somebody to care about them, unless you want a built-in excuse. Uh-huh. Is that what he's hoping for, Skip Bayless?
No.
Is that what you want?
He said nobody gives a damn.
Why you bring it up?
You got to ask about it.
Hey. Everybody's hurt this time of year. Ain't nobody ask you to tell me, well, I'm beat up. Mm. No, don't do that. Uh-uh. You don't think Tom Brady's beat up? Mm. So what quarterback that's been playing all these games is a beat up? What player that's played all these games is a beat up? That's not unique to Baker Mayfield. Mm. I'm not going to let you let him off the hook like that, Skip Bayless. Mm.
I haven't spoken yet.
No, but you're going to let him off the hook. But I can't let you do it. So I'm going to put him back on. You know what? You just take the phone out. You know, phone used to ring busy. Mm-hmm. So you take it off the hook, can nobody get to the phone. I'm going to put it right back. Every time you take it off the hook, I'm going to put it right back on because I want it to ring.
Your phone must have been off the hook a lot.
It was off the hook because we couldn't pay the bill. But that's a different story, Skip Bayless. I'm going to put this phone right back on the hook.
Okay. I'm about to go off the chain on you.
We'll go off the chain.
I'm going to go bigger picture here. The most amazing thing about everything you just said is how it all reeks of Baker hate. I never thought I would see the day that Baker hate could transcend Brady hate. But it has.
Oh, my goodness.
And you know why it has?
Why has it?
Reason number one, relentless progressive commercials on television. Just when I thought they would subside or slow down a little bit, all of a sudden, now we got the Halloween and left the seat down in his house. And the neighbors and what's the other one? Oh, the house sitter one. It's like every week there's a new one.
Yeah.
And just when I can barely take another Baker, what do I see from Nissan? What do I see? I see Heisman House. Well, I don't know how many Heisman winners we've had. Hundreds, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And who gets featured in almost every commercial? Baker Mayfield. Right. He's still the it kid. He's still 26 years of age, and somehow he caught the imagination of Madison Avenue. I don't really get it because he obviously hadn't proven it on the football field. But somehow, and I guess it helped that Progressive is located, based in Cleveland, Ohio.
Right.
But somehow they fell in love with Baker. And I got to tell you, I know how commercials work. They keep testing and they keep getting high marks.
Right.
They are working. Uh-huh. They are. Baker Mayfield is selling insurance for Progressive.
Yeah.
Okay. So the problem is, if I were advised, I've said this 100 times, I'm going to say it 101st time. If I had been advising Baker, I would have said, I'm sorry, we can't do this yet. Even Lee Steinberg with Mahomes, he tried to hold it off for 2 years before he let it go. And now Patrick's doing it all. But nobody has the relentless commercials that Baker has, because when he's playing a game, every commercial, it's another Progressive commercial, right?
Yeah.
And it inspires hate, because you get sick of seeing his mug, because he's obviously acting and he's good at the commercial. I don't have any problem with how he pulls off the commercial. He's very natural in
them. He's better at commercial than football.
Okay, well, you can argue that. Okay. Now, I'll give you that. Even the Heisman House, he's in his bunk, you know, rooming with Kyler, and he's singing Boomer Sooner in his sleep. You know, like, it's just relentless because he's in every one of them. And after a while, subliminally, you despise it because you're just sick and tired of Baker Mayfield. And the only way he can stop the hate is to play. So he goes to Cincinnati without Odell, and they win 41-16. And he was really good, and he did have Nick Chubb before COVID hit Nick Chubb. Mm-hmm. And Nick got loose on a 70-yard run, and the defense played at a high level and took the ball away, and there was an early pick six that turned the game. I give you all the above. But they feed off Baker, because one of the big reasons the Browns picked Baker Mayfield was that John Dorsey called him, and Hugh called him, Hugh Jackson, the Pied Piper of Oklahoma football, because they went to visit and to watch him up close and personal in the offseason workouts. And as soon as the receivers walk in the locker room, they're all looking for Bake, you know, because he's their Pied Piper.
Right.
He's their leader. He's their instigator. He's their inspiration.
And you saw what happened when when the Georgia Bulldogs took that running game away. What could Baker do?
Well, he got beat all to hell in that game. Mm. Okay, so now back to yesterday. He's damned if he does or doesn't. So how is he supposed to answer these questions? Because they're asking him, how hurt are you? Because they want to know, are you going to play Sunday?
I feel fine. I'm going to play on Sunday.
Okay. So he tried that at first, because his first answer was the nobody gives a damn answer.
Right.
Because they don't.
Okay.
He's exactly right. Nobody wants to feel bad for us. So it is what it is. It's all right. Okay. Period. End of story.
Okay. Done with it.
Okay. And then relentless. They're back on you. But wait a second, you're listed with all these injuries. Can you play on Sunday? And he says, look, I'm pretty sore right now, but it's this time of year. Okay, that's fair. Everybody's sore, to your point. Okay, and then he says, one day at a time, but I'll be good. Probably the most beat up. He probably should have stopped right there, but he's just trying to be honest. Probably the most beat up I've been, multiple things, not just one.
So he's not beat up. He wasn't beat up after Cincinnati, huh?
Okay, so he sucked it up against Cincinnati, but you gave him no credit
for that.
Well,
suck it up now. Why you suck it up when you win 41-16, but now you want to cry?
Okay, I don't know this for a fact, but I'm going to educated guess that he's the most beat up right now of any quarterback who's actually still standing and starting games.
I don't think so.
Okay, he's got a fractured left shoulder on top of a torn labrum in the left shoulder. Mm. He missed practice the last 2 weeks because of a foot, undisclosed foot injury. I don't know what it is. And then he hurt his knee. It's sprained. It's probably bad enough he shouldn't play, and he's going to suck it up and try to play again. And as Jarvis Landry said the other day, he is a tough man. I believe he is a tough man. It's no excuse, but you don't even give him any credit for saying, well, I'm just going to go. Mm-mm. And look, what great quarterback has ever been at his greatest with no running game? You can argue Mahomes has been the best at it with no run game, but it's because they don't choose to have a run game. It's by default, because Andy Reid says, I don't want to run it. I'm just going to throw it every time.
But here's the thing.
It's like Steph Curry. You're going to lead the league in three-point attempts. Yeah, you're going to make a bunch of
them.
But
here's the thing. When the other teams, Peyton Manning, I want Peyton to hand the ball off the edge. I want him to hand the ball off to Dominique Rhodes. I want him to hand the ball off to Jay. Because guess what? That means Peyton Manning doesn't have the ball. It's the opposite with Baker.
I know, but you got to keep the pass rush somewhat honest.
I want the ball in Baker Mayfield's hand. I don't want it in Nick Chubb's belly. Okay. I don't want it in Kareem Hunt's belly.
Okay, but so what happened to Patrick Mahomes in the Super Bowl? The Buccaneers
they couldn't protect it.
Yeah, because they just said, you don't want to run the ball. We are teeing off.
Yeah.
Ears are pinned back. We are coming after you, young man. Let's see if you can withstand the onslaught. And he could not.
He could not. No.
Okay. Well, what has happened to your man? Walk it to him, Wentz. He's had a little bit of a rebirth.
You saw that, right?
And what's happening right now? Is there any better, more effective running back right now than Jonathan Taylor?
Yeah, you see,
can you make the case that Jonathan Taylor has put Carson Wentz back on the map?
You ain't want to talk about no walking to him, huh?
Okay, I'm just telling you, he's a product right now of Jonathan Taylor. So if you suddenly go to Belichick and they have caught fire on offense and defense, we're going to talk about Mac Jones in just a moment here. The point is, you walk in the NFL, it's just like any other sport. It's really not whom you play, if I can be grammatically correct. Mm-hmm. It's when. Because if you had caught the Patriots on week one, maybe you go up there and beat them.
Right.
Dallas went up there and beat them, and then all of a sudden they turned their season around. You were walking into the wrong place at the very worst time. Okay, you're coming off your big Cincinnati win, but all of a sudden COVID strikes as it strikes everybody. Like every day I hear another COVID update and somebody else is out. Okay, so now Nick Chubb is gone. Well, Kareem Hunt was already gone. So you're down your best two running backs going to Belichick. Good luck with that.
I'm glad you said that. You heard what you just said?
Mm-hmm.
You said Carson Wentz is a product of Jonathan Taylor. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to admit that Baker Mayfield is a product of Nick Chubb.
Baker Mayfield is better than Carson Wentz.
That's all I want you to admit. And 85 is the answer.
Mm.
85.
85.
How many Heisman Trophy winners?
Yep.
85.
Okay.
Jay Burrow was the first one in 1936.
Okay. Somebody whisper that in your ear?
You just,
whatever. It's fine with me. But the point is, it feels like there are hundreds of them, and they keep picking Baker.
Why is that? Why you do that?
I'm just asking.
You think somebody whispered that in my ear, don't you?
I don't know. Did you just pull it out of thin air?
I know.
Jay Burwanger. Okay. I got it. Okay. So of all those... And they all get featured occasionally in these ads, and they're kind of in a group, or they're in the background, or they're on the couch. Mm-hmm. Who's the it kid? Who gets all the attention, even in the Nissan commercials? It's Baker Mayfield, who I'm the first to admit, who has done nothing. He has done nothing in the National Football League yet. He did win one playoff game. I'm going to give him that. But in the big grand scheme of things, he has done nothing. But I'm going to tell you one more time, because you went real silent last year for 11 straight weeks. I didn't hear from old Shea Sharp over there.
What?
Because for 11 straight weeks, Baker was really good last year.
No, you heard from me. I said, what the problem that I have with you is that when they took off, you didn't want to give Kareem Hunt and Nick Chubb any of the credit.
I give them credit.
No.
I give the offensive line credit.
Why did I
pick them to win the AFC? Because on paper, you can tear your paper in two if you want. On paper, I thought they were the best team, and I don't think I was alone with that.
Yeah.
Because they are. Now, they've been beat all to hell on defense, too. And Jarvis Landry is beat all to hell. And he's trying to go with a bad knee, and he looks about half of what he used to be.
Okay.
So the point is, I'm going to finish that they went 11 straight games without Odell after he got hurt at Cincinnati,
right.
And they went 8-3 in those games. And Baker got graded by Pro Football Focus over those 11 straight starts as the fourth best quarterback in pro football. That's top five. That's special. That's Baker at his best with no Odell. And obviously, they're running and gunning. I get all that. It all came together around the leadership and the playmaking of Baker Mayfield, because he was no longer Odell-centric, Odell-focused, Odell-conscious. He spread the wealth, and he can do that really well if he's healthy. He's not healthy right now, so you have me and him on the run, and your Baker hate is spilling all over the table.
Yeah,
I get it, Skip.
I just call it like I see it. I mean, you don't want to see when they win and Baker plays well. You don't acknowledge Nick Chubb. You was talking about how Baker was pinging.
I brought him up. I'll never forget the Hard Knocks scene. He arrives at the Cleveland airport on Hard Knocks featuring Baker as a rookie. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And some Cleveland Browns fan is standing at the baggage carousel and turns to him and says, "You play for the Browns?" Yeah, I played for the Browns. Think he knows him now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's okay. My point. Mm-hmm. All I want you to admit is that Baker is a product of the system. Mm. He's not the system. Tom Brady is the system. Mahomes.
Oh, now, wait a second. You just made a statement you've never made before. You just said Tom Brady is the system?
Yes.
Wow. You tell me he always needs help. He always needs help.
Skip, I'm saying that even when the run game isn't there, Tom Brady can throw you to a victory. Mm. Can Baker Mayfield, when Chubb and Hunt don't run the ball, when they don't get 100-plus, when they don't run for 200-plus, can he throw you to victory?
Yes, he can.
When has he?
But I told you last year he went 8-3 and went to Pittsburgh and beat an arch rival in a playoff game. See, that was 11-0 at one point. Baker went to Pittsburgh and won.
You know what? Next time
you give him no credit.
Next time I'm going to grade what they graded Nick Chubb in those 11 games, what they graded Kareem Hunt in the offensive. I just want to grade Kareem Hunt and Nick Chubb because I can assure you Nick Chubb wasn't too far behind. Mm.
I will take Baker's leadership intangibles over Carson Wentz's any day, night, any day, week, month, year. I'll take him.
He might be a better leader, but you won't win just many, many more games. Mm.
And we got another QB to discuss. Right? Did you just say hate? Is that
what
it was?
That's what he did.
Hate. Hate from across the table. Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.